What's up, YouTube? The Car Boys back here with another video. Today, I'm going to be adding some more bolt-ons to the car. I'm going to show you guys what those are in a second. But before we go ahead and get into the video, make sure you go ahead and hit the subscribe button, like button, turn on your boy post notifications to be notified every time I upload a new video. Because the build is just getting started. Like, it's more to come. So, shit, just subscribe, stay tuned for more videos. I'm going to show you guys what I got to add on to the TL, the 3.2. It's a base. I already have a, let me tip this down a little bit. I already have a throttle body spacer on there. As you can see, it's red. If you haven't seen that video already, go check that out. But I'm about to add two more bolt-ons today, and I'm about to show you guys them in a second right now. So these are the bolt-ons I got from the scrapyard today. I got this from the scrapyard. It's $15. This is an intake manifold spacer. It helps with torque. So you, I'm going to gain a little bit more torque with that throttle body spacer. So, you know, that's going to add torque. And then I got this cold air intake. I got this from, or short ram intake, whatever you want to call it. I got that from LKQ2. It's $15. The filter was $32. I had to buy a brand new one because the old one was crushed. So I'm just using the tube and a new filter, and that's what I'm adding onto the car today. So we're gonna see what this is gonna, is this gonna help at all, anything like that. I don't think the cold air intakes is gonna do anything. They say it doesn't, but who knows? But that spacer is definitely gonna do something. So I'll flip the camera around. We're about to go ahead and get to installing this thing. So first, you want to take all these 10 millimeter bolts off the top of this panel right here. I already did so. So
I think I can just lift it on up. I think mine's stuck on here. I'm gonna have to pry it up. Hold on for a second. Have to pry it with something that's stuck.
And as it comes out just like that, as you can see, pretty dirty. I gotta clean it. That's pretty dirty. I can't. So I'm gonna clean that, and I'm gonna clean the inside of the rest of this intake manifold. And it's you're gonna take out the inside of here is 12 millimeter bolts. You're gonna take these out, and you're gonna unloosen your throttle body, take the sensor off, take all of these little lines that's connected to the intake manifold, and take all those off, and then You should be good to go ahead and throw that intake manifold spacer on there. But you're gonna have to remove the studs, which I have a stud removal tool to remove those studs out. So yeah, that's what we're finna get done. Day, as you guys can see, I got everything installed. I put this duct tape on here because it had two open holes, so I just put some duct tape on there for now just to close those up. I still have to go to O'Reilly and get a cap for this this vacuum hose right here. And as you can see, the new intake manifold spacer is in there and it's installed. Everything's together, nothing's loose. As you guys can see, everything's on there. And yeah, everything's installed. And she's dead. I crank it up. She's, oh my God, it's definitely louder. It's like, I don't know. It's like it's flowing better. It's louder. It's because I did get my cat deleted. So I did end up getting my cat taken off. And it's much, much louder. So yeah, and it's gained me, oh, in my second and third, no, my third and fourth gear. Oh my gosh, it gained, like I pull so much more now in that gear, third and fourth gear. Bro, it just pulls so much more now. It's just like, oh, it's amazing. That's all I gotta say about it, really.